You're going to want to make sure you have a copy of the molecule reading with you that you can see in front of you. So if you do not have one, pause and go get one. Once you have that, come back and we're going to read this together. And you're going to read it with me as many times as it takes for you to be able to read this back to me on your own. Here we go. Look at the image below of the water molecule. Now let's describe this molecule. This is a singular molecule of water. Its molecular formula is H2O. We can tell that the water molecule is composed of two elements, hydrogen and oxygen. This also tells us that for every one molecule of water, it is made up of two hydrogen atoms and one oxygen atom, for a total of three atoms. If you only have one molecule of water, you will not be able to see it with your naked eye. In fact, molecules are so small that it takes over 1.5 sextillion water molecules bonding together to form a single drop of water. In case you are not familiar with that number, it goes ones, thousands, millions, billions, trillions, quadrillions, quintillions, and then sextillions. That is 21 zeros. So the more water you need, the more molecules you need. Now try to imagine how many water molecules are in the ocean. Next, take a look at the image of a carbon dioxide molecule. This singular molecule of carbon dioxide has a molecular formula of CO2. It is made up of two elements, carbon and oxygen. There is one carbon atom and two oxygen atoms for a total of three atoms to make this one molecule. Now let's compare the molecular formulas of water, H2O, and carbon dioxide, CO2, at the atomic level. Both compounds have two different elements. One element they have in common, though, is oxygen. They both need oxygen to be formed. However, they need different amounts of oxygen. Water needs one atom of oxygen, and carbon dioxide needs two oxygen atoms. Both compounds are also composed of exactly three atoms, but again, they are not the same atoms. Carbon dioxide needs a carbon atom, and water needs two hydrogen atoms. These two molecules do have a lot in common, but small differences make very different substances. So go ahead and make sure you read that with me as many times as you need to until you feel confident to read that back to me on your own.